That's why I don't like this new route, because at the very end of block one, you have to do this jump. And I don't like that jump. Come on, I have to get out of this early game in the run, right? I finally have to get a run going. Yo, Rich, what's up? Thanks for the good luck. I definitely need it today. I've not been playing really well. Best pace I had was 155 ahead after Crystal 1. Oh, after the first Crystal, I mean. Not Crystal 1. But it died at the very end of getting to Bubble 2. And I've been getting really close to Bubble 2 three times this stream, but I didn't manage to get it yet. Yeah, that's why I still play the game, because I will get it eventually, and pretty much after getting it, there's only the Void Tower jump that can screw me over, but that shouldn't be the case. So that was almost a 207. 207 should be doable with my split timing for that. I mean, I'm the only person splitting there anyway. So if you wanna check this out, there's a jump I'm going to do pretty soon that I mentioned in your stream and you kinda knew what I meant, I think. And it's fairly consistent, I didn't fail it once today. Saves a small amount of time, but with this new route it's rather risky because you don't want to lose health at all. So jumping right here always makes it. I didn't fail this at all today, the early cycle here. Well, let's keep on going. Just need to get some health somewhere. Usually I can just keep on going right and I will always get it. So for this room, I just hate it on the way back. I mean, the strat works out, but it just feels so slow. There should be something better. Actually, if I don't get a health drop after now, I only should do one damage boost here. Which, I will risk it, why not? So for the upcoming room here with the skeleton where you have to wait at the ladder, the one after this one. I'm not sure if you figured out a fast strat for it, but I couldn't. I would always get hit by the skeleton if I tried to go before it or try to kill it before going up. Nice guy. No, no, I'm not splitting there. I split when I save warp after this. We are good here. That's when I split. I used to split when safe warping after the block, but now since we grabbed the key, I just made it to when safe warping after the key and deleted the split to not mess up my sum of best. That's why the three splits between map and first crystal are missing, to not mess up my sum of best. Since only those parts got affected by the new route. I've only had pretty bad Vicious Keeper fights today, so you might not want to watch. Like, I could have killed him already. Oh, what was that? I could have killed him already, but I don't know, I just failed this boss fight so hard today. But I don't really care about that for now. 43 should be doable. And yeah, I said it early already, but I'm going to do some serious practice once I get at least a low 44, I think. Oh really? I have to see that. Also, you can jump here and not get damaged by the vines. I didn't manage to do it now. And usually when I don't manage to do that now, I mess up the block jump after as well. But it saves you one life, with which you can use for a later room to then damage boost. I usually use it for the room coming up here. This one, to just drop down, like placing a block in midair and just drop down onto the vines. It saves a bit of time over what I just did here, since you get a pretty good cycle with those guys. And if you're cool enough, you can drop the block in midair and still get the thorns jump after, so you don't get damaged at all. Hey Cactus, thanks for the good luck. So guys, if you don't know that, maybe you do, but Cactus and Rich are both top runners of this game as well. Haven't seen Cactus doing any runs lately though, so maybe he should do that, so I can watch them. You will. That's nice to hear. I really like watching people. So you could previously go over this and it would be faster. I couldn't do that for my life. Oh. Hey. I tried to spawn a block here and then just talk with him, because on the way back your magic meter gets recharged. saves a bit of time, I think. Oh, you've been busy. And I couldn't do that jump over there for my life to the boss, but... I still wanted to be able to do it, even though it's obsolete now. So I tried to do it today, and I got it the first time, and then I could repeatedly do it. I got hit twice even. This is so bad. Yeah, I'm just spying out the strats from those guys. That fight was so trash at the end. I tried to play it safe to not get hit at all, and then I got hit twice. So for this room, I don't know if you guys tried that already, but you can push it in a second time. And it works. What I usually do, I'm not able to do that today though, while dropping from the block above, doing an attack, so you can kinda squeeze in your way to the key already. I was fairly consistent with it, but today's apparently not my day in any means for this game. Like usually I'm just doing a max height block jump here, but I couldn't do that for my life either today. But I'd really like to get one health drop somewhere now. Alright, cool guy. Now I feel way more comfortable. Yep, I got the jump over the gap first try for once. So yeah, I know there is this fast cycle. But nope, not now. That's for later. Yeah, right, I wasn't able to do your strat, so I just came up with this instead. Which I might not even be the first person to do it like this, but it's just what I figured would work for me. And it actually did. It was actually the jump that kept me from doing bubble 2 the first day I was learning this. But then eventually I got it. Oh, another heart! What a nice guy. I'm always scared for this room. I haven't failed it today, but I'm always scared of this room. Probably more like the chance that I could die there instantly, no matter how much health I have. Still hating those enemies. That will probably never change. So I had some issues turning around on that orange platform here today. I even died once because I had that ducking while walking thingy going on and just walked off the platform, which wasn't that nice. Okay, I had a better pace by 2 seconds today already, but this is really good. I like that pace. Can't complain about it. Especially with gold. Oh boy. So, I don't know if it saves time, but I like to activate the switch before going there. It's probably tight, if it saves time or not. Because if you just walk out of the room again and activate a pressure... I'm stupid. And activate a pressure blade, you kind of have to wait a moment until the door opens. So that's why I think it could save time. It's a thing that even if it saves time or not, it's so close that it's so hard to time it correctly. Okay, that's why I lost time, because I was going the wrong path for a second. Actually, for 5 seconds. I dropped another heart. What's with the hearts in this run? So it all doesn't matter how much health I have actually because of this room, I can instantly die here. Or I can do stupid things like that, which is the second time today. The first time I even died to it. Oh man, I play so bad. I will read that in a second, Space Cat. Okay, I got up there. I might just die here still. It's not the first time I die here with just one health. Please. Playing the safe. I want this run going for now. I'm not sure what you mean, Rich Room. Maybe someone else in chat of one of the other runners paid attention to what you could mean. So I unducked too early here and died last run. Not going to do that again. Waiting for this cycle. Just to be safe. Ultra safe. So there's one scary enemy coming up, and one jump that I could fail. I know you can do this without a block, but... Welp. Okay, we made it! Out of block 2, boys! I have to warp. Oh boy, finally run. Now just watch me failing the Void Tower jump. If I fail this now, I will still continue. I can PB with a death there. But I better not fail it. That should work. Yep, that was maybe even too much, I don't know. Maybe I could have saved some pushes there. Get up there. What is the intended way? Well, there are two blocks plus the one you have on your own that you can cast. So you just push three blocks into the gap that pushes the key out, if you mean that. With intended solution. So we have almost a Void Tower jump coming up. Which I failed before a lot. Not in runs, but in practice. This room is really scary. I got it! Oh boy, I thought I would fail it there. This one is always so close that I always think I fail it. My heart is pumping right now because of how close that was. Like, I've never felt as nervous and as hyped about something in any speedrun as in this game. This is just too much for my heart. Yo, check out this almost fresh gold. Yeah, that was a close one, right? I'm not sure if any of you watched the tutorial for the zip. I posted in the Discord. But it's pretty consistent. I should get it. The only hard part for me is placing the block on the bubble, because I'm very bad at that. That doesn't work. Nope. As I said, I'm really bad at that part. That should work, yeah. Like, I know the pixel, but I'm so bad at getting to this pixel. Stand up and jump. Easy every time. And hype music time. Right now, please. Alright, that was almost a bit too early. Okay, got him. Lost some time. Doesn't really matter though. Should I try the jump? Should I try the jump, really? I guess I can try it. If I fail it, it's whatever. I kinda feel like going for it. I feel ballsy. Yeah, right, that's true. It's not like it ruins anything if I miss it, it's just some smaller time loss. Let's try it. I will fail it, but let's try it. That was the best attempt. I'm such a skilled player, if you didn't know. Well, it was to be expected. I'm bad at those kind of jumps. I'm legit bad. And yeah, that's time loss now. Interesting strategy, yeah. Key. I need to get a key. I should actually remember the route. Don't choke away your lead now, please, if possible. Didn't land on it. That's bad. Yeah, I should maybe read my splits. Well, I'm choking away the lead here. But it's not like I have a 2.5 minute time save in the last dungeon. No, 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 definitely not. I didn't die there, and I didn't scrub up every room. That's definitely not what happened in my PB. Ooh, that's rough. Losing time there. So I'm not sure if actually using a bubble here is good or not. I'm just doing it like this all the time. Yeah, it's hard to say, that's why I'm not sure if bubble might be faster or not. But yeah, as you said, it's about the same, that's what I feel like too. Still don't know how to get to this freaking sign up here. And I can tell you, I'm always so scared just pressing up too early and activating the safe spot here. When I'm casting the bubble right here, I'm always so scared to just hit it. I wasn't far enough to the left. It never happened, but you know, a lot of things that never happened before eventually happened. So there's one jump coming up that I don't like. I failed it before and died to it. I don't think it happened in a run ever, but things you've died in practice too are also scary. Come on, no damage. Right, got hit. Doesn't really matter. Ha, I even got a health back here. So this was the jump I was talking about. I died too in practice a lot. Got it here, so it's up to the beholder now. Or up to me rather, if I execute a fight. Almost failed it again and got hit there. Oh boy. Good thing I got a health back at this one guy. Because otherwise, this would be bad now. I mean, I've showed in the past that I can fight the Beholder with just 3 hearts. But I've also proven that I can sometimes not even fight the Beholder with a flask and 3 health. Oh, split I forgot to split again. That would have been a gold probably, because my gold is not optimized since I always forget to split. Right, Beholder, let's be nice. Let me actually get the strat. I hate it when... Oh, he actually destroyed the block. I was about to say I hate it when he doesn't destroy the block. Kill the bat, please! Oh my god. Thank you. Those freaking bats. Okay, I gotta fight. It's all that matters. And bubble to victory. I need to get a flask. Yeah, close one, right? I don't know why. I need to get a practice session for this boss again, because I should never fail it, really. Like, even if I don't get the strat, I should never get hit. At least. Yeah, this bat got a safe spot on me. That's what I mean, sometimes you can stand inside enemies and you don't even hit them. Which is what I don't like. It's why I died on my low 44 paced run on the final boss. Well, low 44 paced up until Beholder. It was only 46 pace at the final boss. So I derped around too much. So I know about this wall jump you can do here, but let's not do that now. Let's just try to get a run going. I wasn't on the lightning, so I got hit, but it doesn't really matter, because you shouldn't need health here. Well, that you could ask that question for pretty much half of my splits, Seal. It's because I like splits. Yeah, I don't know, I just like having splits. Platform, please. Auto split for every screen, that would be cool. Most accurate sum of best ever in any game. No YOLO screen, sure. Gimme those. Not. Gimme that second, or how much it ever saves. I forgot again how much it saves. Was it like 2 seconds? Done optimally? Good thing you don't die here failing this. That would have been the worst. 3 seconds even, holy, I should go for it. It's a ledge time save. .8, okay, I won't go for it. 2.8 is not worth it. 3 seconds, yeah, but 2.8, come on. I'm really nervous. Even though this is not even world record pace. Not even close. World record is world record is even over already. Yeah, of course, the 3 seconds is nice, because it's more than 2.8. It's way more. That might be not good. Yeah, that is not a good position, I don't like that one. The reason why I do this on the left side is simply because I don't want to deal with this right guard. And usually I don't get hit trying this, but we are out of this dungeon. With a big gold even. Not that big, I guess. We need bubble for this fight. Let's hope I just do it. Come on. Really bad fight so far. Just don't die, please. Okay, we got this. Yeah, that hitbox is really something. Okay. Not quite a 43, but it is a low 44. So that means we are going to do some serious practice with this game. That's what I said, right? Low 44 at least means serious practice. Thanks for the GG, guys. And hey, Six, what's up? I don't think you said something in the stream. Like, I lost 5.3 seconds, which is exactly the time that I needed to get sub 44 on the final boss. But to be honest, just look at my first crystal to key split. Hey SpearX, thanks for the GG. Thanks everyone, I hope you enjoyed this run. First deathless run. It was a pretty close one at some points, but it was deathless. So there's only execution I can improve now. Well, this game is pretty much just only execution that you can improve, but what I mean is I don't have anything where I can obviously save time on. Now it's just do the rooms, get strats for them, try to improve smaller things as well now that don't even save that much time. And then maybe tackle on a 42? Like even a high 42 should be good for now then, after doing that, and just keep on improving now. And learn the jump on block 2. I haven't learned it, I just kind of tried to wing it this run and I failed. jump on block 2 saves something like 13 seconds. It's not that much. But it's obviously worth to do. Well, this was a run. 2.5 hours stream, and I got one run past bubble 2, and that was a PB. This is pretty much this game. You just need one run past bubble 2.